What you see on screen is a human karyotype. It's one of the most important scientific advancements in medicine. Why? It just shows in a glance the genotype of a human being. And what does that mean? Well, pretty much we can see the entire, genetical makeup of a person. The individual that we have here on the screen happens to be female. However, if you get to meet her twin sister, you will find that genotypically they're the same. But phenotypically, they're the same. So what's going on? I have another very interesting case right here. The New York Times made an article about these twin sisters. Genotypically, the same. However, the lady at the right, doing fantastic health-wise. However, her sister is not doing so well. She's going through a whole bunch of operations and is getting some health issues. Genotypically the same, though, mind you. But phenotypically different. Our story starts in June 26, year 2000. The president at the time was Bill Clinton. And he was showing something that was going to change science forever. The creation of the Human Genome Project. The Human Genome Project, in general, was all about creating hope in people about curing disease with science. So, a lot of scientists got together and were like, okay, what type of things are we going to be doing with all the power of the human genome? Well, let's start by curing cancer. That's right. Curing cancer was the main goal of this project, to know cancer pretty much no longer as a disease, but a constellation. It goes without saying that everybody was very excited about this, right? It's like, okay, we're going to get to live 200 years. We're going to be able to pretty much cure all diseases. But, boom, some time has passed, and we have seen that not all is written in our genome. There's more things to be explored. So here it is, the results of the Human Genome Project. In general, now we know that we have a certain amount of genes, that we have a certain amount of chromosomes, and all those different things. But let me tell you a couple of things that are not written in the recipe, that are not written under genotype. So the ladies can do a very interesting trick. They have two X chromosomes. The interesting thing is that they're able to shrink one chromosome or the other. But this is not written on your genotype. This is literally written somewhere else. This, we know it as a bar body. So if we check on the cells, you'll find in a cell that there's like a little bundle of chromosomes that pretty much stay right at the bottom part of a cell, and that we know as a bar body, which is that chromosome that shrunk. Very interesting. If we want to see more on the effects as how that is looked at, we have these calico cats. These calico cats are very interesting because they have fur with different colors. So some fur will be black. That is because the colors are mediated by the X chromosomes of the female. So if I shrink chromosome A, that pretty much regulates for the color black, the orange is active, that piece of fur, orange. If I do pretty much the reverse part, well, you're going to get fur that is going to be black. What does that mean? All cells in your body, they're not all the same. We call this a cell mosaicism. And even though they have all the same genome, the way they express is different. Now, furthermore, we're going to be talking about this syndrome, which is known as Prader-Willi syndrome. So Prader-Willi syndrome occurs when there's a deletion in chromosome 15, specifically at a locus 11 to 13. That means that that chromosome is missing some books. So the people that have this syndrome have developed sexual organs. They have mental impairment, deficient growth, and an unusual appetite. That's very important. So the people that have this syndrome pretty much go through their lives and they have this unusual hunger. They cannot stop eating even though they're satiated. Angel man syndrome is the same deletion. It's literally missing the same books. However, the phenotype is very different. We have a speech disorder, we have mental impairment, convulsions, and the most striking piece of evidence for this syndrome is that they laugh and smile frequently. Even though they can be having some issues, they still smile and laugh frequently. Two distinct phenotypes. We have PraderWilli on one side and Angelman syndrome on the other side. But it's the same deletion. So what happened? So, if the part that was deleted came from the fathers, you get PraderWilli. And if the part that was deleted comes from the mother, you get Angelman syndrome. Again, it's the same books that are missing, but it depends where the deletion occurs, mom or dad, phenotype's different. Still, if I put the chromosomes, just pair it up, and I'll find that the recipes pretty much read the same. So what's going on? Obviously, all these questions start to plague scientists. It's like, what's going on? There must be something more to the recipe, which is our genotype. So let me tell you all about it. So, in general, our body has a set of switches that has the ability to turn on and turn off the expression of your genotype or your genome. It has the ability to also work like a dimmer switch. So it's kind of like on and kind of like off. And it works right on top of your genome. That's why we call it the epigenome. So, molecularly speaking, what regulates the epigenome? So we have these three molecules, which are known as methyl. Methyl has the ability to turn off your genome. Acetyl turns on your genome, and the transcription factors modulate. So these guys work like if they were dimmer switches. Now here's the really interesting part. We talked about the genome, we talked about the molecules involved. Now, what are the things that can regulate your epigenome? Pretty much everything, guys. Nutrition, temperature, it's hot, exercise, or lack of, substances, any type of substance abuse will modulate the expression of your epigenome. Stress is actually a big factor for your epigenome. But I have some good news. You are in charge of your epigenome, more than you can think so. Actually, since you're in control of your epigenome, technically, you're in control also of your genome as well. So you are in charge. So what can we do? Well, as stated, to do exercise and have a balanced diet, awesome. Your epigenome will be very happy. Say no to drugs, kids. In general, this issue is really important to modulate in a positive manner your epigenome. And I like to make a pledge for everyone to say no to stress. I know it's difficult. We're in school. We're going through our lives and we're living in quite interesting times. It's very difficult to say no to stress. But let's all try together to say no to stress. So just to conclude, your epigenome is what you make it. So guys, make it a good one. With that said, I'd like to thank you so very much for your time and keep enjoying all these TED Talks.